Who can tell me what you call this ball or this sphere?
Globe.
Yes, this is a globe, okay? And on this globe, there is an imaginary line that runs around the middle. Does anybody remember what that's called?
Belt.
No.
Equator.
That's the equator. It's called an equator, okay? All right, so this is the equator. You guys see that imaginary line that runs around the middle?
Yeah.
You can see it better on the globe because that's where they actually have it. But on the Earth, can you see this line?
Yeah.
If you were looking at the Earth from outer space, you could not see this line. All right, and then the top, at the top of this part, this whole section above that equator is called something. Does anybody know what that is? Adam?
South.
Up is not south. Down is south. So if I'm talking about the part up is not, and it's not just called south.
North.
It is north, but it has a name. It is called the northern hemisphere. Okay, so it is north, but it's a northern hemisphere. So if this is the northern hemisphere, what do you think this part down here is called?
Southern.
West.
Southern hemisphere. Very good. This is the southern hemisphere down here. So this is the northern hemisphere, and this is the southern hemisphere. Notice how it has the word sphere in hemisphere. All right? So it's the two parts of the sphere, above and below the equator, the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. All right, let's put this down over here and let's look at this. This is called a compass rose. Okay? And when you see a map, north is always straight up. South is always straight down. East is to the right, and west is to the left. All right, and then in between the north and the east, you have
northeast.
In between the south and the east, you have
southeast.
Southeast. In between the south and the west, you'd have?
Southwest.
And in between the north and the west, you'd have?
Northwest.
Now, this works for a map. Can you just go outside and say, okay, this is right, so that has to be east?
No.
No. It doesn't
work
that way.
You need a compass to do that.
What would, well, you could use a compass, but there's something else you could use to see what the east is. What else can you use? Yes. Adam, do you know what else you'd use?
Your shadow.
I'm not sure you can totally use your shadow. You'd have to know what you were doing to use your shadow.
On trees, moss only goes north.
I have heard that. I'm not sure if that's true or not, because I've heard that that's not necessarily the case all the time. I think it does particularly... Whoops. Please don't kick it, okay?
Okay.
What is consistent every single day and always in the east and then always in the west?
The sun.
Yes, the sun. The sun always rises in the east. So where you see the sun rising, that is the east. Where you see the sun setting, that is the west. All right, so if you know that the sun rises over there, so that's east, and the sun sets over there, so that's west, then you would know that that direction is north and that direction is south. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So once you know where the sun rises and where the sun sets, then you can figure out north and south from that. All right, let's read in our books now, starting on page 4. All right, and we are going to be talking about Christopher Columbus. Now we know that this is in the 1400s, the late 1400s, right before the 1500s are starting. All right, so that was a long time ago. But what year are we in now? 2020. All right? We are all the way in 2020, so that was hundreds of years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
All right, Chris, 5,000.
1,020 years ago.
No, not 5,000. You guys want to do the math?
520.
Yeah.
520.
Let's actually do. Let's not use his birthday. Let's use the year that he discovered America. 1492 minus 2020. All right, we would have had to borrow. That's going to be an 11, so that's 10. 10 minus 2? 10 minus 8?
8.
11. 11 0. 9 minus 4 is?
5.
5. So that's how long ago from the time he discovered America.
Not
from the time that he was born. We're not going by that. All right, let's begin reading. We're talking about sailors and sea monsters. As a boy, Christopher Columbus watched the large ship sail into his hometown of Genoa, Italy. So where is he from?
Genoa,
Italy. And on here, guys, this is Italy, the one that looks like a boot. So he's from this one right here. I want to get our map moved over here, but they need to put my whiteboard up first. Then I'll get my map moved over here so we can pull it down and look at these places. Genoa was a very important sea town at that time. Young Christopher had many questions for the sailors. What are other lands like? How do you guide the ship by the stars at night? What is the sea like? Are there really monsters in the sea big enough to swallow whole ships in one big gulp? Have you ever seen boiling spots in the sea? Now, this is some of the things that people thought at the time. They lived in the continent of Europe, and they thought all the rest of the world was water. That's what they thought at the time, and they thought there were monsters out there and boiling spots. Christopher wasn't the only one to wonder these things. The sea was a big mystery even to sailors of that day. If they sailed too far from land, would they ever be able to get back? No one had seen monsters or boiling spots, but all sailors wondered about them. All right, let's read in the box. We're going to leave Christopher Columbus just for a moment. Just put your ruler away. I had already told you to put that ruler away. We don't need our ruler for history. We use it in science, and we're doing history now. All right, so this man is Leif Erikson. It is believed that Leif Erikson, a Viking explorer, you guys know the Vikings, right?
Mm-hmm.
Landed in North America about 500 years before Columbus. Many people in Europe had never heard of Leif Erikson in 1492 when Columbus sailed to islands off the coast of North America as he tried to find a better way to reach the Indies. All right, so Columbus was probably not the first one to land in America. Leif Erikson was. All right, the Sea of Darkness. Italy is just one of the many countries on the continent called Europe. There's also Portugal, Spain, England, France, Germany, and Russia. All right, so here's Spain and Portugal. England would be up here, France would be here, Germany would be up here, and Russia is up here. It is part of Europe and part of Asia. All right, if I had my map, I could pull it down and show you better, but we'll have to wait till the whiteboard gets put up and then do that. Just as the United States, Canada, and Mexico are all part of the continent called North America. So this is Canada up here, this is Mexico down here, and this is the United States. Do you recognize that right in the middle? That's all part of the continent of North America. All right, let's read the important words at the bottom together out loud. Everybody reading with me. Important words. Pirates. Sailors who rob from ships. Caravan, a group that travels together, especially through the desert. And then voyage, a long trip across the sea or ocean. All right, now let's read the important names.
Christopher Columbus,
the explorer who discovered the New World while searching for a sea route to the Indies. Known as Admiral of the Ocean Sea. Some of you are not following along with me. Next, King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella, the King and Queen of Spain, who provided ships and money for Columbus's voyage. Nina, Santa, and Santa Maria, Columbus's three ships. In Christopher Columbus's day, no one in Europe knew about America. No one in North America knew about Europe. Most people in Europe thought the rest of the world was sea. Since they had never sailed the sea, they called it the Sea of Darkness. No one wanted to sail this scary, unknown sea. No one, that is, but Christopher Columbus. He was up for some adventure, wasn't he? Alright, so let's stop here and let's look at the different continents again. Just a minute before we continue moving on. Alright, so here's North America. There were people that lived here. But they did not know there were people that lived here. This is Europe. There are people that live here, but they did not know there are people that live here in North America. They did not know about North America. Alright? So, what's this continent?
North America, South America, Africa, Australia, Antarctica, Asia, and Europe.
Alright, now let's name the oceans.
Arctic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Southern Ocean.
Okay, it's pronounced Southern. Southern Ocean.
Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean.
Because remember, guys, all of this would be at the top of the globe. Arctic Ocean, up here at the top, right? Alright, so that's why they got the picture at two places, because that would be the top of the sphere. Alright, and then this one is?
Pacific Ocean.
Because they meet on the other side. This side and this side would meet together, bringing these two together again. Right? Alright, let's keep reading. Alright, let's look at that little map on your book, though. Alright, so we already talked about Italy, where Columbus was from. We talked about Spain and Portugal, and we're going to talk more about that. And then we're talking about the Indies. This area over here is the Indies. This is India, and what they call the Spice Islands, includes Japan and China. That is where they were going to get all these goods that people love so much. And they could either travel across land, which would have been a really long journey, or they were trying to figure out a way to sail all the way around to get there. But Columbus has an idea. Well, if I sail this way, I can get here. And he was sort of right. But he didn't know this was in his way, did he?
No.
So we're going to find out that when he sails this way, he ends up in these islands down here. So it's still part of North America. He did not hit what we consider the United States, but he did hit these islands below us. And that's still considered part of North America.
Miss McLaughlin, he thought those were Asia.
He called it the Indies. This whole area was called the Indies.
He thought that when he landed here,
he'd gotten to the Indies. All right, top of page 7 now. Everybody on the top of page 7. Sailing at last. No one is sure when Christopher Columbus began sailing on ships, but one thing is certain. He loved sailing. Before long, he became captain of his own ship. Back and forth, he sailed to countries that were close by. How he dreamed of a day when he could sail farther to learn about the world. One day, someone asked Captain Columbus to sail a ship to the distant country of England. For the first time, he sailed out into the noisy, restless ocean. The sailors soon learned to trust their captain. He could handle the ship with ease. All right, so let's point again at the map. All right, so he has sailed in this area a lot. Alright, so just around this area. So he's in what's called a sea, even though they call the whole thing the Sea of Darkness. But he is now going to have to sail all the way around here, and he'll be out in the Atlantic Ocean now, all the way to England. So let's find out what happens. What's the next section called?
Shipwreck.
Shipwreck. As Columbus sailed from Spain to England, his ship rounded the coast of Portugal. Suddenly, a group of pirate ships attacked the ship. Columbus would not give up. He fought bravely, but there were too many pirates fighting against him. His ship broke apart and sank, and all the sailors drowned. Christopher Columbus grabbed hold of a large oar that was floating in the water. Holding onto the oar, he kept himself afloat. After many hours, he was washed ashore in the country of Portugal. So that would be right here, okay? So he was trying to sail to England, and then he got attacked by pirates, and the shipwreck, and then he landed on Portugal. He had sailed from Spain, and then he ended up in Portugal when he got shipwrecked. Turn the page. All right, we're just gonna do this comprehension check. Christopher Columbus grew up in Genoa. What? What's the country? Genoa is the seaport town. What What was the country?
Italy.
Italy. Right here, the one that looks like a boot. Genoa, Italy. Who landed in North America probably 500 years before Columbus?
The Vikings.
All right, what was his name? There was a name of the man. They gave us the name of the man. It was the Vikings, but what was the particular man?
Leif.
He's pronounced Leif. Leif Erikson. Very good. And in Christopher Columbus Day, the people of Europe called the unexplored sea what? What did they call this unexplored sea? Owen? Almost. You're turning it around a little bit. You can help him out a little bit. Adam.
The Sea of Darkness.
The Sea of Darkness. All right.